Hi friends, now I am here with a video which helps you to change engine oil, I mean gear oil for a scooter. It could be Honda or any scooter we use on our daily. So you need 12 mm T-spanner. So that it's easy, you need to open two 12 mm nuts or bolts, I can say. So these nuts are, you can see there it is pointing there oil as well as 0.12, that is 120 ml, 120 ml and need to be the oil gear oil requirement. I started using gloves, and this is the video I have shot during a daytime, so the video is really bright with the daylight. Now what we do is I'm going to explain. I had HP gear oil I had replaced earlier, maybe a month or two before, but that time I got lot of metal output. The grinding metal were there more, because that is almost like many years, 7 to 8 years, there was no oil change, so probably lot of grinding happened. So I changed it, so I thought of doing another change, so that the gears are smoother and there is no much more grinding. I'm explaining here, there are methods to fill in. You have to open the top one. This is the top nut. You can open that nut or open the bolt, I can say. This is a bolt. So top one, the oil, the engine oil starts pouring in to the mug we place there below. Then we need to open the bottom one. Get the remaining gear oil from the bottom hole, because that is the lowest possible hole in the engine gear area. So I should have rotated the wheel a little bit to get the oil come out completely. I use the WD-40 for cleaning these nuts with the washer. So that it cleans up. WD-40 is a multi-purpose oil. It can help in many ways. Any keys, any locks, where you have tough time, difficult time, so you can just spray a little bit. Any bolts you want to loosen them, you can apply this. There are multiple, it's a multi-purpose oil, I can say. Let the dirty engine oil ooze out. Meanwhile, what I try to show you is I have these nuts are already cleaned and I am keeping it there. Now I bought this HP gear oil with a 90 grade, and I had a local which I had emptied into this Kinley water bottle while I changed the first time about a month or two ago. Now bought a new canister. In that canister, what I am going to do is I will fill those locally purchased 90 grade engine oil. You can fill your engine oil through this canister, but to find out the real quantity of 120 ml, you need some kind of measurement. So for that I have a syringe of 10 ml. I'll pour this gear oil for 12 times. So 10 multiplied by 12 equal to 120 ml. This locally purchased gear oil I'm pouring into this canister, so this can be useful for any kind of top up or any kind of oiling purpose, any joints anywhere. You know, normally if you go to a local mechanic, they use burnt oil, they don't use these gear oil. So I'm going to use this gear oil. This is little bit thicker, it's not burnt, it is unburnt, this is fresh one. I wanted to use this, so I purchased this HP bottle which is 500 ml. Used once, so this is the second time. So this is a locally made EP90 gear oil, Omini, that is filled into the canister. This is useful to oil any of your parts, any moving parts in your bike or car, wherever you need to oil them. You can use this. So I have purchased this to facilitate those from you know. And once you oil these from the canister, you need to wipe off the area, otherwise dust accumulates and it just creates unnecessary messy area near those joints. So oil it and clean it immediately, so that the joints only need oil, not the outside of the joint. All right, this ready. So you can either do go to the upper hole and insert through this oil, but I don't want to use this local 90 grade Omini oil. I am going to use the HP's, so I am going to use this syringe with the pipe I used last time. So the same syringe I am going to use this time also. This is 10 ml. We'll wait till the oil comes out. Let me tilt the vehicle little bit. If we get a little more remaining, some more remaining gear oil might be there. Yeah, I still get. Let's wipe off this area. The inlet as well as the bottom one, which is normally the outlet. Let's fix the nut. Let's fix the bolts. We have these two. These bolts need to be fixed. Either one, these are same size, so either one can go there. So let's wipe off, might be some dust. Correct. Still some gear oil is just coming out. Let's the bolt. with a washer in, then tighten this with the T-spanner up 12 mm. This is the easiest tool I find for this oil change. Yeah, it's done. Let's get into the filling part. Let's fill the engine oil, sorry, gear oil, which is HP 90 grade. 80 to 90 grade should be okay, because this should be thicker. What Honda recommends is 90. So this syringe is 10 ml. I have to count and fill in 120 ml, that is 12 times. 10 times is 100, then another 2 times makes it 20 ml. I am just showing you, it is 0.12 liters, so 120 ml, 120 ml. Let's fill in. This bit tight because the oil is thicker one, and the syringe takes every bit of it with the pressure. So yeah, I get the full syringe, so 10 ml. Like that I am going to fill 12 times. Let's do it. Okay, we can close the top nut, but I feel, you know, we did not do exactly 10 ml every time. So I'm just pouring little more into the top hole. So anyway, beyond 120 ml, the oil cannot stay. It just comes out from the top hole, the inlet. So we are just tightening that bolt. So the oil change is the gear oil change is done. Now need to start the engine and let the wheel rotate. It's in the center stand, so let the wheel rotate and let's see. I should get a smoother ride. Thanks for watching, friends. So I have you can see this cloth, a lot of oil just fell off. So don't spill any oil on the floor, you just wipe off and use this waste gear oil responsibly. You don't have to throw here and there. It has to go to the oil dealer, or they will do the normal disposal of this oil so that it does not harm the environment. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks all. Thank you very much.